Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to explain how you can calculate addresses of 1DL. So with the help of a formula, we can identify address of a particular index of 1D array. So for that, first I am going to write the formula. Then I will be explaining that formula with the help of an example. So this is the formula through which we can calculate address of a particular index of 1D array. So here we have various terms. So let's understand those terms first. So A is 1D array here, right? So one dimensional array. So wherever we are using capital A, so it will be representing 1D array. Now K. So K is the index of element whose address we want to calculate, right? So this will be the position whose address we are going to calculate. Then BA, so it is base address of array. So base address of array means starting address of a particular array. Then so this is covered, this is covered, this is covered. Again we are using A, so A is representing array. Then we have W. So W is word size of data type. So W is the word size of a data type or element, word size or data type of element in memory, right? So let's say you are using this array as of type integer. So for integer, size of a particular block or its data type size is, let's say, 4 bytes. And if we are talking about long int, or we are talking about float, double, long double. So in that case, sizes will be different. So as per your data type or whatever element you are storing in memory, so W will be telling you the size of that individual block. And A is already explained, and LB here means lower bound. So lower bound will be always 0, because the first index of each 1D array is 0, right? So now I am going to, after this explanation, I am going to take an example so that we can calculate the addresses. So let's say if you are working on 16-bit compiler, so in that case size of it will be 2. If you are working on 32-bit compiler, then in that case size of it will be 2. So I am going to tell you both the scenarios. So let's say we have one array in which we have various elements to right. So these are the elements which are stored in this array. Now we need to calculate the address. So we need to calculate address of this second index. So if I create the array, so these are 8 locations, these are indexes, these are the values which are stored, and let's say beginning address is 1000. Right, so base address of this array is 1000. So if we are working on 16-bit compiler, right, 16-bit compiler, if you are working upon, so size of int will be 2 bytes. It means each block will be having 2 addresses. So first we are going to understand this. So now we need to apply this formula. So base address is 1000. So base address of A, this we have calculated. Then plus W will be 2 because we are working on 16 bit. Now K is the index whose address we want to calculate. So it is 2 minus lower bound will be always 0. So we need to put that. Now 1000 plus, so this will be 2 into 2, 4. So finally, what will be the output? It will be 1004. So the first block addresses are 1000 and 1001. Next is 1002 and 3. And this is starting from 1004 and it will go to 1005. So here you can see at beginning address of A arrays, second index is 1004, which is totally correct. Right. So if a particular location is having multiple addresses, because if location is having more than one bits, so according to the number of bits, that location will be having those particular addresses. So if location is of 2 bytes, so it will be having 2 different addresses. So the beginning address will be identified with this. Right. So this I explained you for 16 bit. Now if I take 32 bit example. So in that case, this int will be of 4 byte. So rest of the thing will remain same. Only I need to change this. And 4 into 2 will be 8. And the result will be 1008. So here, from 1000 to 1000D, these 4 bytes will be reserved here. Then 1004, 5, 6, 7 are reserved for here. And starting from 8, 9, 10, 11. So 1008 to 1011, these 4 bytes will be reserved for this second index. So here you can see 1008 is the result, which is correct for this second index. So here you can identify this. So this way, you can calculate address of a particular index for 1D arrays through this formula. So I hope you understood how this formula is working. And you can apply it on any data type. So the data type which you are using for array, you need to put the memory size in place of W, and rest of the things are very simple. So this way, I hope you understood how we can calculate address of a particular index in case of 1D arrays. And if you want to watch more videos related to data structures in algorithm or data structure with C, so you can go to description of this video. You will find various links there. Also, at the end of this video, I have put those playlist links, so you can follow them there as well. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.